Hello there, everyone. Osage Orange here, and welcome to this BTS episode, behind the scenes episode of Let's Play Minecraft Series 2. As appreciates everyone who has come out here on Osage Orange Gaming BTS. I know that it's been a while since we last done an episode. I thought since it's just been over a week since our last episode of the main Let's Play Minecraft Series 2 has come out via Twitch. We should do something here on the Osage Orange Gaming BTS channel. So make sure to go ahead and leave a like, hit that subscribe button here on the BTS channel. Make sure you go check out the main action over at Twitch on twitch.tv/OsageOrange. Make sure to check out the content over on the main YouTube channel. Make sure to leave it a like and hit that subscribe over there at youtube.com/osageorangegaming. Make sure to follow me on the twits over at twitter.com/osageorange01. So anywho, let me see here. I'm going to pull up Minecraft. So here we are. I have managed to do a fair amount of work. Bearing in mind, of course, I've got a IRL stuff, you know, job, all that jazz. So, as you guys can see, we've got more or less the foundation worked out here. So, what we're gonna do, I'm gonna do a little bit of railway work for the minecart system. This is one of the things I have gotten done. Just give you a quick glance, and so sort of what we're going to be doing is we're going to be laying the track down here on the this side for this minecart right here. Let's see here. Let's go ahead here. I think most of those rails are going to be topside, so we'll just quickly check in there to make sure that there was the appropriate gap for the detector rails. The momentary brain fart there. So this episode was in essence inspired by fellow streamer Dravella. That'll be you can find her over at twitch.tv/ Drevilla, that is Drevilla. Link will, of course, be in the description. I hope you're watching this, Drev. So, yeah, as you have hopefully seen. Oh, car tracks right there. Department of Duh. you know, we've got fun with all the smelter stuff. This episode's not going to be too long. Probably about an hour or so. I'm going to do, aside from this, we're going to do a little bit of smelter work, as I said. Also do a little bit of stuff topside with the item sorter, I hope. Alright, so let's see here. Let's go and roll way down the... don't want that. We got glowstone topside right up here. I went ahead and filled these in, so it's both upper and lower layers are glowstone. I've also done a little trick right here. Oh, it's nighttime. Just need to come over here to check the track. Now let's see here. Got some power rail. We're gonna have to make up some detector rails. So we'll first start off with what we got in track. Oh geez. Tree just realized he was being dumb with the laying of all the track here. Department of Duh. Of course I don't have a pick. Tree is dum-dum. Alright. Let's go get ourselves a pick. We're also gonna have to fire up some iron at some point. So let's go ahead here. We'll also lay down the track, or at least start laying down what track, power track we can. That way, it shouldn't take too much, of course, to be able to make up more power track downstairs. See, we're gonna need sticks and pressure plates. There we go. It was momentarily, I was like, what's the word I'm looking for? Oh, pressure plates, Department of Death. All right. Let's see here. Yeah, that was not so smart. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm thinking that we can go ahead and use these guys as our zeros. So let's see here. What we're going to do, I'm thinking we'll put somewhere here in the middle. We're going to go ahead and precisely figure that out. We'll put in a small booster set of track with stuff. So let's see here. 6, 7, 8. Leave a gap for the detector rail there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. 1, 2. Yeah, we'll have that'll be perfect. That will be perfect. We just need something, a little something of a booster. So as the system here can do its thing. Let's go ahead here. We're gonna don't have any pressure plates there, unfortunately. I think I should have some over here in the system, in the redstone stuff. Let's see, redstone. Oh, good. Get some see, and while we're here, I'll pick some gold. And set that one oddball there aside. Oh, that's right, we also need some sticks! I know I'm forgetting something. Oh, sticks! Department of Duh. Got some sticks downstairs, so let's go ahead here and scoot that guy there back. Well, at least we got tons of sticks. There we go. I knew I had some wood down here. I'll just put this pile of sticks back, and then iron. Duh. Done goofed on that. Forgot to put the wrong minecart. Forgot to put the granite there. Trees, dum dum. All right, let's see here. We also need some iron. Yeah, let's go ahead and do that. Excuse me, but it felt good. All right, let's go ahead. Yeah. That's definitely going to be more than... Well, when you think about it, we're actually going to need a fair amount of detector rails to... eventually come through and help out with the system here. Let's see here. I'm gonna go ahead and put the sticks there. Just put the... Come on, there we go. We may have to fire up some more iron. That's... I'm not iron, gold. The permanent is dead. Just making sure we didn't have no iron in the system. So yeah, another thing I've done is installed some glass, and of course have took the end of the what's it area to the other end of the smelter. So that's another gonna have to be. Let's go ahead and fire up some gold, flint coal, perhaps. See how much. Let's see. Do I have enough for three blocks worth? Let's see. There's my calculator. Department of Duh. So 80 times 3 divided by 64. We have enough for three blocks. Huzzah! Let's go ahead here. Toss that bad boy right in there. Let him do his job. In the meantime, let's go ahead and do ours. First, start to in place, if we can, of our detector rails. Dum-dum. I had thought originally about perhaps using this center one as a wall, and then I thought, well, wait a minute. If I ever have to come down here, I don't want to have to, you know, try to choose one side. Dum-dum. Choose one side or the other, so we'll go ahead. So I said, let's go ahead here. We're going to put in a walkway. As needed use maintenance walkway. We should have fired up the guys with all the iron, too. We'll do that here soon. Alright. That was smart. Come here. Thank you. 1, 2, 1, 2. Let's double check the up system here. So. We also need to put up some lighting here at some point. I'm going to use some torches. Yep, these guys, they are ready to rumble and roll, so, dust is good. Dust is very good. Yeah, here's the, one that eventually we're gonna have this go out and be up in space, but for the moment, we're gonna worry, not about that, so, so hopefully downstairs, Dosh Schmelter has been processing the gold. Splash! All right. So what we need to do is we can start with that one. 2, 3. Need to head on over here to the other end while I'm thinking about it. Still need to take this out a little farther, probably at some point down here, but for the moment, I'm not going to worry too much about it. Place these guys. Gap. Oh, too much of a gap. Dum-dum. It's a rather long stroll. See, boom, boom, and boom. There we go. So yeah, basically there is going to be, as you've seen me do, we've got three lines. This run right here down the middle, more or less, is going to be the personnel line. Basically, how I am going to travel under the smelter. That way, you know, we don't have track, you know, obstructing the view of the smelter. So that it can be nice. This guy right here, this is going to be the freight line direct from the mineshaft. This is going to be, you know, andesite, nether, andesite, diorite, granite, redstone, lapis, diamonds, emeralds, etc. You know, all the good stuff. You know, iron, gold, coal, that's going to go into the smelter, of course. And this right here is going to be the smelter line. So what we're going to do, this is going to kind of let the smelter finish it. Just toss these guys right there for the moment. Let's make sure we put away the pressure plates. Where in the bloody blazes? There they are. Hoppers. And we better snake some more. Box coal. That's going to be, let's see. I think that's going to be enough. Let's see here. Calculator. I just had it. There it is. Department of Dup. Double check here. Let's see. Let's go ahead and toss those guys in. Get that guy going. Let's see. 64 times 3 plus 23. 15. I don't want to be inefficient in this regard, so what we're going to do, I'm going to go ahead here and put that guy back, chuck those two in there, let's see, 215 minus 160, that's going to be 55, seven lumps of coal, so we're going to need three more, 1, 2, 3, boom, let's run right over here to the, that's you. Put those guys into standby mode so that they will go ahead and chuck stuff in. So anywho, while we're waiting for that good stuff to happen, let's quickly get our way out. Shovel. I'm going to go ahead here and I'm going to clear out. We're going to have to do it the hard way. So we're going to have to replace it with glass. Department, duh. This is why I was like, duh. the shovel. Guess we're gonna get to recycle the stuff we're recollecting. All the stone brick derived goods, nether brick, obsidious. Come on, thank you. So yeah, what we're gonna do here is basically both got this, and then here at eye level, these are going to be glass, and then where, for example, this regular stone is, that is going to be lava. So I have already, as part of operations, gotten some stuff ready for the lava. Checking there to see where we were. I was like, I know we're getting close. Here we go. Boosh. So, as you see, I've got this is an upside down stone brick stairs right there, and then we got some glass so that the lava can be providing light out that way, and same thing on the far side, sort of thing. Just gonna clear this a little bit here out. I know I got glass down here somewhere. We'll have to take a look-see here in a bit. I hope we won't have to worry too much about going to get sand. Hello there, bloody gravel. Now, well, I'm thinking about it. Let's go ahead and pop up here. So, this part mostly so I can explain to you, Drev. I know it's kind of dark now, and we already got the stuff up more or less to max. But in terms of furnace count, as I said, as I told you in that one live stream where we were talking about it, going to be 192 furnaces, and they're going to be in two. This is what I call a double back, part of an advanced double back arrangement. Basically, what we're standing in right here is block 3. And then between that guy and that guy, in this zone right here, that's block 2, both sides. And then from there, just this side of that obsidian pillar there in my crosshair. But from right here to right there is block 1. Let me go ahead and give you a little bit better view. So yeah, this right here, from here to here, no, it's dock, is block 2, and then from here to here is block 1. Because block 1, you know, we're doing from the mine shaft, and this is, of course, going to be the mine shaft proper. So, you know, block 1, block 2, and then, of course, there at the tail end is block 3, where we're currently have as the quote-unquote active part of the smelter. And of course, it's the double back refers to the loop around of the mine, of the operations, basically having things operate in a giant circle. Because the way I've got this sort of worked out, and we'll sort of coming up with this particular design. There are basically, I've got three subtypes of smelter. I've got four types. Type 1, which would i.e. be the Mark 4 from my 1/8 world. Then this is a type 2. And a type 1 is basically a single-sided smelter. So, you know, if all these furnaces, you know, including these guys, were all in a straight line on one side, that's a type 1. This right here is a type 2, where we've got, onto the left, in this case, left and right furnaces, you know, furnaces on both sides facing one direction. That is a type 2. And this has led to the development of 3 subtypes. And in this case, this particular smelter is a type 2 subclass Bravo. This means, essentially, is that, let me see here, for example, the big boy, the Mark VI, that would be a type A, subtype A. Basically, it is the main gallery. Main gallery is where it's at. Subtype Alpha, or type A, subtype A. Subtype Bravo, subtype B, is this. Basically, with the loop around, basically, when we get, you know, this part of the smelter built up. Well, actually, we need to go to the other side, because that's the cobblestone side. So basically, since this is, for example, the metals pod, metals block, basically, the track, you know, when we finally get to installing it from the base, based on the prototype, of course, basically, what will happen is minecart will come down one direction, flip around, come back, then it'll go back alongside the outbound track, the inbound, back up to the distribution system, be routed to the appropriate subtrack, because, you know, we're going to have iron, gold, netherite, and metal tools, i.e., you know, gold armor, metal iron armor, gold tools, metal iron tools. And the minecart will be routed back to its appropriate distribution system, where it will then receive its load will be refreshed, and then it'll come back and repeat. So, you know, it'll essentially go from the end, from the one end of the refreshing chain, it'll go down. Then go be back to the head end of the refreshment chain, and then go down like that. That's basically what this more advanced double back system is gonna do. Okay, so let's go ahead here and go ahead and combine those. Let's go ahead here. We're gonna put some of our. Oh, I need to call you out. Let's see here. Excuse me. There's those. That. Tree dum dum. Tree is dum dubbed. Boosh. All right. Boom boom. Let's see where up. Dum dum. Boom. Hold on to those. Oh, there you guys are. Boom. There we go. Go. All right. Let's go and put those spinners there. Wrong minecart tree. Boom, boom, boom. See, let me pull out this water bucket and put it there. Get the rest of those buckets. All right. Oh, that's right. Duh. I was thinking, I'm forgetting to do something. And then I realized, duh, we need to come here to the cobblestone system. Cobblestone system can have something of its own thing. A little more complex than the, certainly larger and longer than the metals or the other blocks, you know, like for food, netherrack, clay, sand, etc., etc. So anyway, basically it's going to come down like this. There's going to, design that I've gotten, that I'm currently working with, is each of these guys is going to have their own subsystem, sub-distribution system. Basically, both sides are going to have one that comes down on one side that feeds on this side, loops around, then come and feeds on this side. So it's sort of the, each side gets its own subsystem out through. This is an additional waste of iron, some would argue, but I do it as a necessary evil. Where bloody blazes did I stow that glass? I know I got glass. She has confuzzled himself. There it is, Department of Duh. So, well, I'm thinking about it. Don't want to do that with the buckets. Let's get those out of the way. Dum-dum, go downstairs. So what we're going to have to do, right quick at least. Kind of forgot about that. Well, that kind of, I'm not going to worry about installing these hoppers. I need to take a look at installing stuff for the extraction system before I set up hoppers coming across, because I was originally wanting them to come right here underneath the glass. Now, yes, that would be true to block the lava, but at the same time, this is like, you know, look it up and see, oh my god, one little mistake, and, you know, we got lava everywhere. So that is why we gotta be careful. Alright, so enough of talk about that. Let's put these hoppers right back in here. Let's go get ourselves some lava. Yes, we have got lava. So. Silly torches. Ow, ow. No tree, no bunny. All right, what we're going to have to do is a little trick like this. Can do that. What's it there? All right, we got the starts to lava here. Let's go ahead. I'm going to get rid of that. Gonna be doing some obsidian mining along with our stuff here. So I knew that in this case that mining the obsidian is gonna be helpful for us. Snag the thing without having to worry about going around. Huzzah! We may have to make up some more buckets. So, what we're gonna do, Yes, I actually like to do what I'm doing right here. Ah! Tree is dum-dum. Basically, leap across this thing without falling in. So what we'll do, right quick. Let's do that. Pull out some glass. Placing of lava is not easy. Easy at all. So do here. What we're doing here essentially is securing our own safety. Boosh. There we go. Go ahead here. We're gonna run back. Let's go ahead and oh wait, dum dum. Forgot three more buckets. There we go. Let's go ahead and combine that. I think we're gonna go ahead here and get rid of these frickin' torches. I know it's kinda dark. I do have my brightness all the way up. Alright. As we get into obsidious, we're gonna then chuck it into the system. Toss those torches there. And make up another. Let's see. Go and chuck that there. See. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 more buckets. There we go. Buckets. And then come on over here. Some of the lava to despawn here. Oh, thank goodness the obsidian was there to help protect us. Huzzah! Go ahead and probably gonna have to come out and mine some of this stuff out. Let's see, we got some room. Yes, we do. Let's go and get some more obsidian. Oh, hello. Hello. Not huzzah. We're deliberately going out to the farther reaches to get our, our stuff. It is as you can see, we're starting to get some glow here. Let's see. You always have to be careful with using lava as lighting, kids, because if you're not careful, you can easily burn yourself up. Alright, so let's see here. Two more. We'll use these two buckets. So, there we go. Alright. Yeah. Let's get that out of the way so we can deal with one set of lava buckets at a time. So basically, by having 8 more buckets, we can cut the amount of effort we need by at least 50%. Alright. Quickly get these guys out of the way. Boom. Oh, jeez. I meant to do 4 on one side, 4 on the other. Tree is dum-dum. Yeah, look at that. See, there are no torches. No torches. Let's go ahead and let me show you guys what things look like from underneath. When I came up with this for the Mark VI, it was like, oh, this is going to be neat. Let's take a look-see here. A little bit of flowing lava. I wanted to deal with that. But yeah, look at that. Got some light. Steady light coming from our lava source blocks. See, if we were to have the flowing lava blocks, let's see here. And now you see from at least the bottom, it doesn't look too bad. But of course, from the top, it looks absolutely horrid. So that is why I worry so much about putting down whole lava source blocks. Let's go ahead and check the glass out of the way. Let's go ahead and get this here. Oh, I almost went the wrong way. Boosh. Alright, lava. Go away! Lava, go away! Lava, go away! Come here, Obsidious. You are mine now. Yes, you are. Ah, darn it. Figured there would be something like that. Now, this, pick that we got right here. This is our general working pick, so that I don't have to worry quite so much about wearing out a. Oh, hello, they're cold. So that I don't have to worry so much about working out my my netherite pick, which is a good thing. See, I'm gonna go ahead and toss that. Let's bring you up to there. Move you there. The lava reacts here. Still flowing down, down, down. Alright. Now this is the work pick for on lava. Settle on down, Steph. Settle on down. Ta-da! Huzzah! We have... Let's be anti-dum-dum here. Let's quickly reload. Well, one thing of one lava source block left. Let's go ahead and pick up this obsidious. There we go. Now we are on peaceful because in this case, you know, dealing with the lava is such a huge pain in the butt. So let's quickly here, down this way. Ready? Alright. So we'll make up from our boo-boo from earlier by putting in the necessary lava there. There we go. Huzzah. Let's go ahead and quickly seal this up. So is that... Excuse me. Quick OCD check. All right. So now, let's go ahead quickly here and seal this part here up. We can come in over on this side, do this side. Just making sure. Huzzah, we are, of course, in alignment. Dust is good. Dust is very good. You see, this is one of the more dangerous aspects of installing this part of the smelter. However, when you get everything lit up and lit up like you want it, it can be a very good thing. Whole bunch of iron awaiting us, so dust is good. Hopefully, we won't have to worry too much about glass. So let's go get our guy from down here, our sole remaining lava source block. Or what should be our sole remaining source block. Dust is good. So we've got here, under this area, fair amount of stuff for lava. And this is starting to feel better. This is starting, for me at least, this is starting to feel like it's melting. Alright, so let's go ahead and get you out of the way. Boom, let's see. One, two, three, four, five, other side now. Star Wars Episode 6. Brace your inner feelings, boy. Let the hate flow through you. Have enough glass, we may have to go topside. Yeah, now that I think about it, we can actually perform a mathematical calculation. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 30, 31, 32, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 40, 41, 42, 43, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 50, 1, 2, yeah.
We're gonna need more.
Because... See, we only got 53, and I just succeeded. We're gonna... While we're thinking about it, let's go get some sand. We'll put what we've got of the smelter through its paces. And I'll to mute the game for you guys. Or at least, mute the in-game audio. Alright. Unmute. Boom. Boom. Get some sand. Unfortunately, we need to get some hello horsies. I thought I'd gotten enough sand. But the obvious answer is a resounding negative. Yeah, we're coming to back up over here where we originally had our food farm. Get up, get up. I hate that thing that whenever they install it, it's like, I do not want this. Too deep though. Yes, I have to. Come on. Oh, thank goodness we don't have to worry about any of the baddies. So. Go ahead and bring it up to 2 full stacks, I think. Work we need to do with dirt, soil, whatever you want to call it. I know it's not necessarily always the same terminology, but you know, I use soil and dirt interchangeably. Let's get our stuff. And now I just saw that coal, but I'm not gonna cry or spill the milk. There we go. Make sure we get all this freaking clay. Not clay, sand. What you're doing, at least in theory. Let's see, go ahead and just deposit the sand, don't have to worry about it. At the same time, it keeps it in strategic reserve. Oh, that is a good phrase to think of, strategic reserve. I know I said earlier we'd probably be doing some work on the item, so I think we're going to forego that in this BTS episode. Our time will be better spent focusing on smelter ops, so... Move yourselves, pals. So, as our mass should be right, correct, we can put 4 furnaces to work. get that reorganized there. Don't do that tree. There we go. All right, let's go ahead back out to our lava collection point. And just start to collect up some of the subsidies here. To seriously know that spontaneous combustion is not a good thing. Get stuff further here out of Givet. I'm having too much fun leaping over this little trench we got. Keep dokey out of chokies. Let's go ahead here and we're going to get our lava placement again. How fitting is it that our thing here comes up to this obsidian line right here. Security glass. That's one thing I love about having glass is that, you know, it lets the light through. Same time we're not falling into that lava. Oh no, 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 tree, go, 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 tree. So, it was bound to happen, guys, it was bound to happen. It was bound to happen. I was thinking, I knew that at some point, and this always happens at some point, is that during the installation of the lava lighting, we have that sort of event. Mm-hmm. snag up this obsidian. What we can do, this is a careful trick, is sort of thing. When we're in the LP proper for series 2 here, we did have this little encounter of the lava kind, so now, part of what I was thinking about, let's do the lava first. Don't be a dim dim. Alright, so what I was trying to say before I got to this, before I was worrying about all the lava here, was the command areas for the control panels here. Basically, I was sort of inspired, you know, we were talking about Star Wars a little bit ago, sort of inspired by the command pits on, you know, like the, God, what was Vader's ship's name? It was the Super Star Destroyer. God, I forget the name of it off the top of my head. I know it's in, I think it's still in canon. I know that was when Disney took over Star Wars, they took the expanded universe and retconned it into Legends to help sort of keep things going. So anyway, basically, sort of took the idea of a command pit, you know, the central walkway, and yet having these command pits. But it, I also wanted the sort of the feeling that, you know, you still, you know, on the Mark 6, you know, you still had this, you know, feeling that, you know, you've had a lot of smelter over you. I just really wanted to really sort of have that feeling of smelter being over you. So that's a good thing. Or at least creative-wise, that's what I wanted. Excuse me, but it felt good. So let's go check our glass. Excuse me. And then once we get our stuff here, we'll finally work on the track. Let's go ahead and suck out all our stuff here. All right, metals. my tree brain was momentarily blanking out there. Let's go and get that cobble. It's that way. Ooh, oh, should be over here. Duh. Boom. I'll put away the obsidian. Double boom. See, let's make sure we still got room. Yep, we do. We do. Tree is being good. Not as much of a dim. Wrong turn. We want to go this way. In this case, it's a good thing that we're using up all this lava from from an area that was being a huge pain in the butt early. Alright, let's go ahead here and do this. So yeah, basically, like I said, you know, I wanted to, how can, you know, that's part of the design ethos with any new smelters. You know, what's something that can make it a little more unique? You know, now true smelter, most of my smelters are going to be designed along the same basic lines. So, especially of late, how they're being built. You know, they're being built along the same basic lines, and while there is always room for improvement, that is also why I try to do things different. Which, come on, push the right key there, tree there. I hate it when I try, when I'm so busy looking at my keyboard, my screen, and not looking down at the keyboard, you know, it's like, why am I not pressing this I just wanted to try this sort of, and you know, it'll be arced up, we'll have our center glowstone roof and that sort of thing, but you know, I wanted something a little bit different for the commander, because you know, last smelter was just a little bit up. This one, I just wanted something a little bit down, and this might become a aspect of a future smelter design. You know, having, you know, this sort of thing. Because, at least in theory, it'll help make for more room above that part of the smelter. Let's see here. carefully mine this way. This dum 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 dum. Wrong thing there, tree. There you go. We're almost there. We're almost lit up. I'm so curious. I don't remember what the name of Vader's personal Star Destroyer was. Let's see here. Don't want that. Let's see here. Vader Star Destroyer. All right, that is not what I was looking for. Executor. Let's see, it was his personal Star Destroyer was named Devastator. The Executor was the name of his Super Star Destroyer, or Star Dreadnought. Built at a cost of 325 billion credits. Which is, of course, absolutely, positively ridiculous in scope. Now, let's see here. Get these lava buckets. More to go, do we? Huzzah! Like I said, I don't think I'll ever be able to get over doing that sort of hopping thing. Alright. Oh, gotta be careful. Like I said. careful. There we go. Come on. You know I'm going to lose that obsidian, but I would rather take that. Oh. Huzzah. Look, we've got the water right there for our system, for our drop shoot system. Sorry if I'm quieter, guys. I'm just trying to focus. You know, I can get so focused on the task at hand, you know, it's for me I can get quite involved. Finish up this one, see if we can finish up this one side, or see how much it's gonna take to finish up this one side. Three more. Six, so that is going to be 16 plus 3 is going to be for both sides. That means we only need to fill all but 2 buckets, so go ahead here. There we go. All right, so hopefully this should be the mathematically accurate count on the number of buckets we need. There we go. Let's go ahead and put that guy there. Actually, no. Don't be a dum-dum tree. Do not be a dum-dum. Excuse me, but I felt good. Thank you. have the correct number of buckets. So, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Gosh darn, now I'm thinking Monty Python. 1, 2, and Monty Python and Holy Grail. 1, 2, 5. Three, sir! Three! There we go. We have our lighting system. Huzzah! Indeed. All right. So let's go ahead here. Sort out our stuff. I can go right there. Glass gear right there. Pick. Stay with us. Glass. Piece of there's the obsidious. All right, let's go ahead and pull out excuse me, the necessary tracks. There we go. All right, so let's see, we need to make, of course, some more power try. I don't need emeralds. There you go. Let's make sure we do that. Department of Duh. Itching leaves. All right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. All right. Go ahead here. We're going to take out. The torches here. Along the what's a track here. Come back on down here. Alright, so this is this thing from this smelter from this line of obsidian right here to the line of obsidian down there by our stuff over yonder is 117 blocks long, including the two obsidian ones. So, as you see, that is quite lengthy. Alright, so now, I just kind of realized. Ooh, now that's an oak. Just a sec, guys. I am quickly going to take a break. I need to go use the little trees room. I will see y'all here in a few moments. Sorry about that, guys, but when you gotta go to the little trees room, as I had to do just now, you gotta do what you gotta do. So, let me go ahead here. Come on, game. Minecraft, there we go. Okay. So, the, you know, I realized that, you know, with this right here, that we've got the two systems here. But, the idea that just popped into my head is we can go ahead, this will allow, still allow for a dual track system. And so basically, and this will be allow us to do a thing. So let me go, let's go ahead. We're going to worry about these two guys right here first. So let's go ahead and do that. Actually, yeah, no, this is the hard tree is dim dim. Let's get that out of the way. This one as the needed one. So yeah, for my person to track. For, oh, yeah, yeah. Doing it right. Tree's doing it right. I like to do a thing where I do something like this, where basically we go 20 track. Have detector rail, three power rail, detector rail. That way we can move the needed number of blocks quickly and rapidly. We can do here. Let's quickly install the powered rail here. Let's see, I want to see how far is it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's not going to make much difference. I don't think it will. So, besides, you know, yeah, doesn't make much sense. Or, actually, 1, 2, 3, 4. Problem solved. There we go. My OCD was starting to go off, so. Anywho, what we're going to do now is on these guys, go for every 20. Lay down 20 track, plain track, regular track, whatever you, it is you want to call them. Before we put in the 5, that is to say, 2 detectors, 3 powered. So let's say, take this down to 24. As you know, chess minecarts are finicky when it comes to, being activated and all that jazz. So 1. Looks like we'll be able to make it work. That works. A little off. Ooh. That's an idea. That is an idea. All we can do. Let's nature of this arrangement, what we can do is a little something like this. There we go. All right. Three, boom. So this should be 10. Huzzah! Well, not quite. Yeah, it works. Alright. So for this guy, what we're gonna do. Make sure we do this mathematically correct. There will be an extra track in this case. Now what we're going to do, we're essentially going to bring this guy up to right here. Essentially bring him up to right here. And then for these guys, for the extraction system, I'm gonna do what I can to try to have it come over. And then what I'm gonna do, I'll just sort of, well, that's right, department, I kind of forgot about that. Well, it's a good thing that I'm gonna try to use suck stuff up. But basically what I'll do basically make it to where the minecart on this guy here turns, so as that we still have the gap. So let me go ahead here. I'm just going to put this in thusly. I'm going to work on it later. I'll work on it off camera, but basically I'll tear out the obsidius. What I'll probably do is lay down like stone brick right where that track starts. It's actually a good idea. Let's take advantage of the stone brick here and lay it on down and say, hey, dum-dum, remember that you need to fix this. But basically, we'll have this be a turn-off for and I'll still try to find a way to, I'm going to have to mathematically figure this out, how to do the connect over, but let's worry about this here for now. So, 1, 2. See here. Maybe 22. Here, coming from the other side now. Use this guy here as our alignment. All Oh, wait, that's right. Should be off by two. One, two. Yep. Yep, it's off by two. That's all right. Because in this case, I'm willing to have that little bit of a difference between our stuff here. So let's go ahead here. I'm going to quickly just flush our track here. Let's go ahead and get the rest of our glass. That is it. So we've got the rest of our metals. Bada bing, bada boom. We can go vroom. Huzzah! Basically, as I was saying earlier about the minecart stuff, sort of the plan is to have a centralized in this case, trying something out. Have a centralized system where the one side help fill onto one other, trying to basically reduce the number of tracks, with the exception being this side. So what I'm going to be doing, I'll taking out that obsidian, take up the whole wall right here, so that way this guy right here becomes our new wall, and wherever the I'd have to check the prototype, we're not going to worry about that right now, but wherever the system ends up having the this extractor here for blocks 1 and 2, the system, you know, however I get that set up, what we're going to have over here is a hookup, and it'll eventually wherever the extraction system is, I'd have basically, it'll come out when where the stone brick is. Basically, what would happen is I will have it, the two automated extractors, they'll come through on their joint line. They'll merge the two tracks from this side. They'll merge on this side, you know, right here. You know, I'll have, you know, a switch right about here, depending on however I get the system set up for the extraction system. And so yeah, it'll come over here, we'll have the switch on whichever of these two blocks. They'll both be able to then proceed up over here to this guy. Well, actually, let's be smart. Nah, we'll keep it the way it is. Because hopefully, you know, switch over one, and it'll come up hopefully as it charges through, it'll hopefully come through like right to here, and then on the side when I have the switch over to the line, I'll have it switch over, and it'll the guy'll be able to go and he'll hopefully push both of them there. So huzzah, hopefully this will work out for us. Go ahead here, back away, bada bing, bada boom, we can go room, huzzah, huzzah, huzzah. Yes, when am I putting my last tree? There it is. I was about to say, tree totally forgotten. So anyway, as appreciates to everybody, there we go. Tree ring is kind of going right now. I appreciate everybody who has come out to this Let's Play Minecraft Series 2 BTS episode, featuring, of course, the still incomplete, but work slowly advancing here on the Mark 7 Heavy Challenger Smelter. If you're watching here on Osage Orange Gaming BTS, remember to leave a like, hit that subscribe button. Make sure to check me out on Twitch at twitch.tv/osageorange. That is where all the live stream action happens. Make sure to hit that follow button. Make sure to go subscribe and like stuff over on the main YouTube channel over at Osage Orange Gaming on YouTube. And of course, make sure to follow me on the twits over at twitter.com/osageorange01. So yeah, guys, I always appreciate everybody who has come out, and I hope to see y'all in the next episode. Ta-ta for now.